my life for the sheep. Has it not done? He did it. How many, you know, flock owners, how many people that they are cattle rearers who died for their cattle? Then he came to lay down his life so that we can live. Amen. And look at verse 16. He said, and other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and there shall be one fold and one shepherd. What is he talking about? He's talking about the unbeliever out there. Among them are still the shepherd of the Lord Jesus Christ. But they have not come into the kingdom of God. But he said he will also bring them in, so there can be one fold, right? And one shepherd. One fold and one shepherd. They will hear his voice. And I want to tell you this morning, love brothers and sisters. The unbelievers out there, they will hear the voice of Jesus Christ through you and I. When you go out there to talk about the goodness of the Lord Jesus Christ, testimony actually is for believers. If you have any testimony, share it in your job place, share it in the mall, share it at the grocery store, gas station, because unbelievers will not believe without signs and wonders. So they're going through everything that has not been working. Then if you, somebody may say, I'm even confused, I don't know what to do. And you don't know, just walk to them and say, everything's going to be okay. Worry, I know somebody who can help you. If all have failed, I know this one person that can never fail. Have you tried it? It's my friend. Are you ready? Really? You know this person who can bring you out of all your trouble? Surely they will be excited to know. Then who is that? It's Jesus Christ. So that the people outside in the world will hear the voice of Jesus Christ. It's when they hear the voice of you, believer. Amen. That is the way they will hear the voice of Jesus. And when you speak to them, then when they are by themselves, Jesus Christ now will now minister. Bring afresh every word you have spoken. When they are alone, God will now highlight that word back to them, their mind and their thoughts. They can't go back through it in their thoughts again. Before you know it, say, I'm ready. I want to know this Jesus. You know what I'm saying? So this is what he was saying here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse 17 says, and therefore does my Father love me, because I lay down my life that I might take it again. No man taketh it from me, but I lay it down of myself, and I have power. And I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received from my Father. What is Jesus saying here? If he did not willingly desire to die for the world, he wouldn't have died. He has the power not to die. But there will be no salvation. There will be no redemption for mankind, because there has to be blood shed. And it has to be a blood that is clean, pure, and holy, that can pay the price for the sins of the whole world. And that was why he was born out of a virgin Mary. Are you getting what I'm saying? So there was no mixing of. You know that he's the man that carried the head. But how did Mary conceive? By the power of the Holy Ghost. So, what are we saying? And that is why his blood, the blood of Jesus, is the perfect blood that paid for our sins. No more sorrow. Because he chose to die so that you and I can live. He died so that, and then we come to struggle in your life. And then we come to hardship and difficulties. That was why he died. And he shed that blood. Every covenant is a the blood. But the blood of the everlasting covenant is the only blood that is effective from generation to generation until second coming. In that, that blood has no spot, no wrinkle, no blemish, no pollution, no contamination with the nature of man. Are you getting it? Jesus, the good shepherd. So, verse 27 again, he said, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish. Neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. But do you know what Jesus is saying? What should give their life to Jesus Christ? It is assured. Your life is saved. Your name is written in the book of life. What Jesus is saying is that if you remain saved and keep saved, the devil, the enemy cannot block you out of the kingdom of God. Then, however, you yourself can walk yourself out of the fold of Jesus Christ. By the lifestyle you live, a lifestyle of disobedience continually, it is not once saved, forever saved. So that will not be the fault of the Lord Jesus Christ. That will be the fault of any child of God that will be today. I love you, Jesus. Tomorrow, I'm in the world. Do that, even though Jesus said, never perish. If we walk out of Jesus, we lose our cover and our protection. That's why we need to stay inside Jesus. Walk, no matter how high or whatever the cost, we need to remain in Christ Jesus. Don't compromise with sin in order to please human being. Don't do what Jesus hates. Some people do it because they want to be of everybody. Are you getting what I'm saying? If you are a people pleaser, like in Saul, it's dangerous. Are you getting what I'm saying? I want to add, I don't want to offend anybody. Because that kind of person, you want to be a friend to everybody. You know who you are going to offend? You are going to offend the Lord Jesus, the Good Shepherd. Because the Bible says, friendship with the world is enmity with God. You want to leave them. That's the way they want to live their life. Leave them. That's good. I'm not saying condemn anybody. Jesus never condemned people. But you can let them know that the Lord is not happy with this kind of lifestyle. I'm talking about gay lifestyle now, you know, lesbianism, you know, bestialism. All that nonsense. You can't be in the church of Jesus Christ and be doing all that and still believe that you make heaven. Hallelujah. Verse 29 says, my Father which gave them me, you know, is greater than all, and no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. This is assurance that we maintain our relationship Lord Jesus Christ. Never turn our back to him. And you get what I'm saying? For example, talking about the issue of marriage. Discover that in this generation, when the younger ones, they don't care. I mean, I know nobody can tell me. I'm an adult. I know what I'm doing. I can't date anybody. Honey, yes. Can date anybody, but the consequences of dating the wrong one, you're going to live by yourself. Your parents that are telling you don't do it, they're not going to live with you when the consequences come. Are you getting what I'm saying? So don't say I'm an adult. One day, my mother was my daughter, my first daughter. Then she was first year in college. My mother said, "Ah, now you are not in the college." She said, "Oh yes, grandma." She said, "Eh, so what are you supposed to do here?" She said, "Ah, I'm putting an account, studying accounts." She said, "Oh, okay. See, you graduate 4 years from now. I must not hear that you have a boyfriend." Distraction. Say you won't be able to focus. Say you face one thing at a time. You are there to read. Read. Then when you graduate, after your graduation, if you don't want to go further, yeah, you can have a friend. But for now, my daughter said to me, "Say your mother at this age. Stuff like this, mommy. What did you go through? I'm afraid of your mother." I said, "Oh, don't worry. You don't need to know." Me, that I asked my father, "Is this the woman that gave birth to me, or is she my stepmother?" She's the mother of all of you. I didn't marry a second wife. Yeah. What am I saying? Don't say I'm an adult now. I can handle it. Can handle it now. Then the consequences, the after effect of what you are doing now, you can handle it. And you get what I'm saying? It's good to listen. My mother, when I talk about it, because if she was part of what I've been through in America, I would have lost focus. You get what I'm saying? Jesus, our good shepherd, leads us to where there is great passion, where there is great opportunity. And you get what I'm saying? All you need to do, keep asking. You need a better job, asking for it. You need whatever, asking. Nothing is beyond his ability. He has a eternal life. He has joy to give. He has health to give. And he's strong enough to defeat all your enemies. That's the person that we should all give our lives to and hold on to him. This end time, whatever. It's traveled so fast. And therefore so many people have been open to danger. They were not open to danger. You conversing with people on the internet, you don't know who they are. You know that they are killers. Are you getting what I'm saying? This is dangerous end time. Cannot live our life carelessly. You to make sure that you are covered in the blood of Jesus every day. Jesus said, end time, heart of men will fail. End time, men's heart will go cold. People will be lovers of pleasure. They are lovers of God. People will be haters of those that want to please God. So don't be surprised if on your job you are the only Christian, and when you say you are a Christian, they sleep at you. The end time, signs of the end time. There should not be discouraged. Will you not go to work and say, I'm not my Christian, let me join them when they are talking nonsense? Every idle word, the Lord Jesus said, that come out of our mouth, give us account on the last day. So my brother, my sister, my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the sea waters. He does what? He restoreth my soul. So I broken. He will mend up your broken heart. He leads me in the paths of what? Righteousness. For what purpose? For his name's sake. Because I am called by his name. Say, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anoint my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Look at the last verse. Surely, goodness and mercy shall do what? Follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. So, if whatever news we get on the TV, radio, or internet, should our hearts fail? No. Because the good shepherd lives forever. He cannot die. Call upon him 24/7. Line is open. You can never hear, leave me a message. I'll call you back from here. It's available 24/7. Jesus, the true shepherd. Hallelujah. The giver of abundant life. His power is unlimited. His resources, they have no end. And the joy he gives, he can never run out of joy to give. Amen. He can never run out of peace to give. Everything we need to live a successful life is inside the shepherd, the Lord Jesus Christ. Why should I have a need that is not met? Why should I struggle? I've given my life to Jesus. Everything is uncompromising life of sin. Doubt and unbelief, disobedience, stubbornness. Hallelujah. But today, the thief has lost. The thief is Satan himself. Are you getting it? Why is he a thief? He troubles people that do not belong to him. You know what I'm saying? Takes from people what he did not give them. And you get what I'm saying? If God said you now praise me, God has the right to say praise me because he made you, because he has been keeping you, he has been preserving your life. God has the right to say praise me. But Satan is forcing people to worship him. People he did not make. Yield yourself to? Is it the good shepherd? Who knows where the best he has prepared for you? Who will lead your footstep and guide you to your safe haven blessedness. I want you to talk to him now. Talk to him. Thank him for being the good shepherd. He knows where the good nourishment is. He knows where the good opportunities lies. Hallelujah. Before you know about your own needs, he is already aware of what you stand in need of. Thank him. Give him the praise for being the good shepherd. The good shepherd is always going ahead of us. He doesn't come behind us and allow the enemy to finish us. Talk to him. If you don't know his voice, he said his sheep, they know his voice. Ask him now that, Lord, open my ears to know your voice. Talk to him. Lord, open my ears to know your voice. He said the voice of a stranger, his sheep will not follow. Talk to God. Lord, speak to me. I want to hear you. Pray that prayer. Lord, speak to me. I want to hear you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Talk to him. I give you 1 minute to talk to him. Hallelujah. Because he desires that we all know his voice. So that he guides us through his voice. He directs us and leads us. He instructs us. Many times to avert dangers. That's the reason why you need to know his voice and to hear him. Say, Lord, I want to know you and I want to know your voice. Lord, I want to hear you. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Well, that is the word of God. Make altar call. Is there anybody here? You are not assured of your salvation. Still have this question mark. Am I really saved? There's nothing wrong if you rise up to give your life again. Hallelujah. Don't be ashamed of that. So that there will be assurance that your name is indelible in the book of life. That's the purpose of that. And again, if you are in this service, you are sick in any part of your body. He told me he wants to heal. Are you sick in any part of your body? Is there anybody here who have diabetes? You have diabetes. You have arthritis or leukemia? But this one specifically what he gave me. Is there anybody suffering from all this? The shepherd, the healer, is in the house. Anyone who are sick? When I was preparing, this is what he told me. He said, he wants to heal the sick. So if you are sick in any part of your body, can you come out? Hallelujah. So you won't go home the same way you are coming. So I'm telling you, God in this service desire to reach out to somebody that had a leukemia. And you know that is cancer of the blood. Arthritis, diabetes. Those, they're supposed to be here, but now they are suffering, relocated, since they were not in the service. Lord, I give you praise. I give you glory. Can we just worship him? Just wave your hands. He's the healer. wherever you are now, be on your feet. The Lord will touch you on your seat. Yours may not be sickness and diseases. Let your heart be open towards the chief shepherd, the Lord Jesus Christ. Destroy now forever by the anointing that is in the blood of Jesus Christ. Go forth and be free from discomfort, sickness and diseases, because the shepherd, the good shepherd Jesus Christ, has come to make you whole. Jesus' name. Amen. So everybody be on your feet. Your love for Jesus Christ has gone cold. You slide back. You don't get joy again. To read your Bible is a struggle. You want to come forward quick. Inside of you right now, in Jesus' name, I command that lukewarmness to lose you and go far away from you forever. I call for the fire of God to burn inside of your soul, the purging fire, the refiner's fire, the purifying fire of God. Burn inside of you now. Yes. Yes, I command your memory to be quickened. I rebuke that memory failure right now in the name of Jesus. Rebuke it. Yes, by the mighty blood of Jesus Christ, the quickening power of the Holy Ghost, quicken your memory. Activate it. Receive the strength of God. You are delivered. Every attempt to slow you down is cut off now by the hand of God. You cannot be slowed down. Your glory cannot be exchanged. I forbid that and I reject it. Your bread is not transferable. By the mighty blood of Jesus Christ, I decree. Go forth and live that life that God created for you.